Yekto.
I'm Ali. My classmates, as you know, Hippolito, Habon, and Baredu and Nicholas. And in this presentation, we are going to explain to you about the company that used to do very good, but now, unfortunately, they kind of failed and they're not doing really good these days. This is our presentation for BT organization, as you already know. And the company name is Libratone. This is the company that we chose. I mean, the name explains many things about it. You can see it's Libratone.
Yeah, it's okay.
This name has meaning and it's connection with the signature of Libra means liberation and tone means sound. So the whole signature is in the name. The goal of the company is to free the sound. And you can see the bird on top, which is kind of simulating that. And under that, you can see the Scandinavian things. But because this company is actually, as I said before, is a speaker and audio product releasing company. And it is based in Denmark, in Copenhagen. The main office is in Copenhagen. And yeah, the company was founded in 2009 by a man called Tommy Andres in Copenhagen. And his goal was to, you know, make a company that has fancy and stylish design, high quality build and high quality sound. And also here you can see another thing in 360, which you might know what is 360, I mean it's the dimension, and it is like all the products, the speakers from this company are 360 audio. I think you all feel that way, like sometimes you go to a party, someone put a speaker in the middle, and some people are saying, I can't hear the sound. Some other people say, it's too loud for me. That's because the sound is distributed only in one direction. But in 360, it means like the sound is the same everywhere. And you know, one direction sound for speaker is not really good, though I really like Harry's slide. But yeah. And yeah, what they did good. I mean, I say they at the end kind of failed and they went back from bankrupt in 2020. But they did something good. For example, the build quality of the speakers were really good. And also the design was really good. For example, you can see the flagship of the company, which has really different design. And you know, the design is really important for this thing because they have so many competitors. And if you have a unique design, whenever someone takes your speaker or your product, everybody gonna be like, I know this speaker. So the different designs show the characteristics of your company. And also advertisement, they did quite good job in the advertisement. For example, you can see one of the advertisements here. I don't know why she's so charming, but yeah. Yeah, you could see this advertisement anywhere in the internet. Just a surprise. Yeah, I don't know what this speaker reminds her, but yeah. Yeah, and advertiser was quite good too. But the next slide, yes.
Unfortunately, for some reason, my presentation wasn't recorded from that part. And as you can see in this picture, there are three speakers. In the left hand side, we have Harman Kardon Ayura. In the right hand side, we have JBL Boombox. And in the middle, we have Libratone Zip. And the problem is just about these rivals. One of the biggest problems of Libratone was goal of product. And as I said before, the thing is, for example, the JBL Boombox in the right hand side is a waterproof speaker and it's rigid, it's kind of what I don't know, bulletproof. You can take it to mountain campaign, I don't know, wherever you want, and it will stay safe, and you know, you can do whatever you want with it. But it has a big battery, so it doesn't have really great sound. I mean, the sound is really good, but it's not as good as the Harman Kardon Ayura, which is in the left hand side. And Harman Kardon Ayura, it doesn't have built-in battery, it's not waterproof, it's not dustproof, it's not, I don't know, bulletproof, nothing, it's not rigid. It can break down so easily, and it's more like an artistic design speaker, and it's used usually for desk, not for taking out. It's not portable, as I say. So these two speakers have totally different goals. Harman Kardon has the better sound, better design, but JBL has more, I don't know, it's stronger. But in the middle is Libratone, which try to do both of them at the same time. Libratone has a Wi-Fi connection like Ayura. It has built-in battery like JBL, and you can take it whenever you wherever you want like JBL, and at the same time it doesn't have, it's not waterproof, bulletproof, I don't know, it's not as strong, and you can take it to mountain or those places for camping, and it's not water resistant just like JBL. So this is where the problem starts. Libratone didn't know their customer, because if you want to have a speaker to have be portable, you need big battery, which Libratone Zip kind of had, but they paid for it. They trade big battery with a good bass, and at the end the speaker didn't have a really good bass because they couldn't fit in any subwoofer or big woofers inside the speakers on any heavy radiators, so the bass was way lower than both of other speakers. And the thing I'm saying is really important to know your customer, because if you don't know, then you will end up with like this. Libratone tried to do everything in one speaker, which the result wasn't good. At the end they have all the features. You could play music from USB, you could take it wherever you want. The sound quality was good, but bass was low and the sound wasn't loud that much. And yeah, but everything was mixed, you know, it did many things, but not with the best level and in the average or maybe lower than average level.
They couldn't put each of the components inside the speaker for producing these frequency ranges. So at the end, they had to remove a component for low frequency and they merged it with this component for the medium. So at the end, you got a mixed sound. Everything was mixed, not the sound system. And yeah, at the end, if you're really into music and audio system, you're going to be really satisfied with the speaker. So in here, they lost some customers too. And yeah, this is a summary of what happened to this company. Yeah, that was the problem. So the whole point is like, if you're making something or you have a product, never say I want to have everything in one product. Try to categorize and decide on what you want to have in this product, and also don't forget about priorities. So this was the presentation, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. Thank you.